Hey guys, this is Joe Dawson here with my friend David Markham, the president and founder of Truth Infusion Ministries. And David, he has a powerful ministry on the radio. He's a preacher, he has a worship band, and does a lot of stuff. And we just want to talk to him about what he sees going on in the region. So as you go out and you travel and you do ministry in this region around Texarkana, what are you seeing the Lord doing in our region?
Well, Joe, one of the blessings that I'm so grateful to the Lord for is the opportunity to be in all different kinds of shapes and colors, right, and sizes, congregations, different names over the doors. Here's what I'm finding, though. A lot of common threads running through all different kinds of denominations right now. I'm seeing in a lot of different places a similar dissatisfaction. A lot of pastors are saying some of the same words. Right. And one of the things that I'm hearing a lot is this: we're ready for something real. Mm-hmm. And they're becoming dissatisfied, I believe, with the status quo, with the same old, same old. This is the way we've always done. It's just not working for a lot of congregations anymore. Mm-hmm. They're hungry for something that they can't explain.
Right.
A lot of times, you know, I've been in the churches where we this is how we do it. We go by this list, this lineup, and we sneak God in between some of the songs every once in a while, give him maybe an altar call or two. And people are seeing what the Bible says, and they're looking at their personal lives, they're looking at their church lives, and they're saying, why doesn't this really add up?
Right.
And they're looking for something real. And so the neat thing I'm noticing, Joe, is this. It's happening at the same time in a lot of different places. Right. God is preparing something. And you and we were talking just a little bit earlier. I believe he is preparing for a revival.
Right.
And I think it's going to be a little bit different than what America has seen in the past.
Right.
I don't think we're going to be able to pigeonhole it or corner it and say, this is how we're going to do it. Mm-hmm. This is what it's going to look like. I think it's going to come from the mouths of men and women that maybe never saw it coming out of their own mouth. Mm-hmm. And it's going to happen in ways where people have to stop and say, I don't know really what just happened, but it wasn't me and you. It must be God, so it was real. And I think that when that happens, a satisfaction is going to come that these people are looking for, these congregations and bodies are looking for, and I'm excited. I tell people all the time when they are excited at the end of a service or an event or something that I've been able to be a part of, I say, look, I was just glad to be in the room.
Right.
Watch God do what God does. More and more I'm after this, the more I'm seeing, less of me is the way to go.
Yes.
Because God can do what he's up to, what he's wanting to do. And I believe that when that revival comes, and I don't think it's going to be a bam, it's already here. It's just like not here, now it is. I think it's going to be a progression that we grow into, and we're going to wake up one day and realize the tidal wave is rolling, man. And this is it. It's on. Right. And I think that it comes, I think a couple of things have to happen. In every revival, you look back, even with Josiah in the Old Testament, to 2014, there's a couple of things that I believe takes place in the midst of every revival. And one of them is repentance.
Yes, definitely.
Confession and repentance. Here's the truth. If we don't have something to confess and repent for, then we don't need revival. We should already be there.
Mm-hmm.
But sin is still the issue.
That's right.
I believe sin's still the issue. So it comes at the forefront with repentance from sin, aligning ourselves with God, and then prayer, prayer, prayer. And when we said amen, let's pray a little bit more.
There you go.
And on the heels of those things, we really are just getting ourselves out of the way and opening up for God to do what God's going to do. Look, he's God.
Mm-hmm.
He's not waiting for our permission. We're either going to be in the room or we're not. It's coming.
That's right.
That's what I believe.
All right. Well, God bless you. This has been JoJo Dawson with Burn Texarkana with David Markham. And I'm going to encourage you to look up my friend David Markham. And if you're looking for somebody to preach or do worship for an event, look this guy up, because he's full of the Holy Spirit. He's full of the power of God. God bless you.
Thanks.